If BJP and Shiv Sena alliance comes to power in Maharashtra, Fadnavis will remain chief minister. That is what Amit Shah and Narendra Modi have been saying in their rallies, that Devendra Fadnavis will continue to be Maharashtra's next chief minister. However, there is a chance that after 3 years odd, Fadnavis could be elevated to a role at the central level in party organization or in the union cabinet, depending on Mr. Modi's and Amit Shah's wishes. Chandrakant Patil, who is at present number two in Maharashtra cabinet, is also an ambitious leader. He is close to party president Amit Shah, and he has been asked to contest assembly election for the first time. So far, Mr. Patil has been a member of legislative council, but this is the first time that Mr. Patil has been asked to contest assembly election. This is being perceived as a signal that in case Mr. Fadnavis goes to center after 3 years, Mr. Patil can then be asked to take over as Chief Minister of Maharashtra. Fadnavis has not sidelined the Maratha community. In fact, after the Maratha reservation issue and after High Court upheld the decision of the government, Fadnavis is being actively projected as the Brahmin chief minister who gave reservation to Marathas. That is the kind of message that BJP leaders, the BJP's Maratha community leaders, are trying to send it across community. So it would be wrong to say that Fadnavis is sidelining the Marathas. Why? There were reports in a section of media which claimed that Fadnavis defeated Marathas. I wouldn't say that. What has happened this time is the tact and sincerity shown by Fadnavis in addressing Maratha reservation issue was never shown by previous governments or previous chief ministers. And because BJP has the government at center also, he got a strong backing from the national BJP as well as all his leaders to tackle this issue and unrest of the Maratha community. There was a feeling in 2016 end that Fadnavis may be replaced because of Maratha agitations. But the way he's tackled it is extremely well. And now after the High Court has upheld the decision of Maharashtra government, Fadnavis, party is trying to protect Fadnavis as the Brahmin chief minister who gave reservation to Marathas. BJP's term will be smooth in Maharashtra essentially because if you have seen, all the potential threats to Fadnavis have not got tickets. Mr. Khadse did not get tickets, did not get ticket. Vinod Tawde did not get ticket. Prakash Mehta did not get ticket. Chandrasekhar Bavankure did not get ticket. Among these four names, Mr. Khadse being senior to Devendra, in the initial years when he was in the cabinet, he used to address Chief Minister as Devendra, Are Devendra, or listen to me Devendra, which didn't quite go down well in the party and men close to CM. Once you become a chief minister, you have to observe certain rules and protocols. Chief minister has to be addressed as chief minister. And in private functions, you can call him by his name, but not in official functions or not in cabinet meetings. Secondly, in case of Vinod Tawde, you will see that CM and both Chandrakant Patil, they tried to secure a ticket for him. But for certain reasons, Mr. Amit Shah has not been satisfied with Mr. Tawde's performance. Reports went to Amit Shah that Mr. Tawde's handling of education ministry, Mr. Tawde's handling of Marathi language ministry, Mr. Tawde's handling of cultural affairs ministry was not effective. And that has resulted in Tawde not getting a ticket. Tawde also was an chief ministerial aspirant in BJP. So all these seniors who had ambitions like Kharse, Tawde, Prakash Mehta, they have not got the tickets. So essentially, I personally feel that Fadnavis will have a smooth term. We reliably learn that CM had told Uddhav Thackeray that Aditya should first get experience in Maharashtra and then graduate to national level if he aspires to do that. This is an indication that if Shiv Sena BJP wins, Aditya will have some important position. If they are in opposition, he will be groomed as a leader who can unite entire Sena rank. He will be they will make sure that he is most vocal on issues which are concerning people. Overall, the strategy is to project Aditya as a leader who is cosmopolitan as well as close to his Maharashtrian roots. I cannot talk about numbers or how many seats Sena or BJP or NCP or Congress will win in Marathwada region. But when I traveled there, I could sense a certain degree of anti-incumbency among people of Marathwada because of continuous drought that they have suffered because of agrarian crisis, which doesn't seem to be ending at all. If they come to power, initial period, Sena and BJP will have nice equation. There will be a lot of bonhomie. However, Sena has made one thing clear. It will participate in the government and it will continue to play the role of opposition also. Because Sena has sensed that the current opposition, the opposition in the assembly which is ending, was weak. Congress and NCP leaders, all of them had some or other scams against them, which made sure that they were not very vocal against this government. Sena used that space very effectively. Sena continuously attacked the BJP government whenever it felt that its policies were wrong or were anti-Maharashtrian. You take any issue. Farmer suicide issue, farm loan waiver issue, agriculture insurance issue. Sena was very aggressive on all these issues. What role the opposition parties could not play, Sena has played. So Sena will continue to play this role. The case against Sharad Pawar would have had a huge impact. After the registering of offense, and the day when Sharad Pawar addressed his press conference and said that I will not bow before Delhi, Maharashtra will not bow before Delhi, there was a huge sympathy wave for Sharad Pawar on the social media. What created problem was on the same evening, his nephew Ajit Pawar resigned from the post of MLA without giving any explanation, without informing any of party seniors. That confused the NCP rank totally. The message was sent that this is kind of some kind of family feud between the Pawars. And then Mr. Pawar had to issue clarification that I am the senior, being the family patriarch, there is no feud in the family and Ajit listens to me and all that. So wrong signals were sent by Ajit Pawar's resignation, and just yesterday Mr. Bhujbal also has questioned the timing of Ajit Pawar's resignation. So whether this sympathy translate into votes remains to be seen, but one thing for sure, right now Sharad Pawar is the lone fighter from opposition who's actively taking on Shiv Sena BJP. He is literally tearing their administration, tearing their governance to pieces.